When is the best time to replace your running shoes? Today, I will share my top tips to help you understand when it's time to say goodbye to your old pair and say hello to a new pair. Hi everyone, my name is Rohan. Welcome to another episode of Fridays in the Essex Lab. No matter if you're a beginner or an experienced runner, your running shoes are your number one tool. The perfect pair will not only help you reduce the risk of injury, but also help you reach your full potential. But, like almost all things in life, running shoes have an expiration date. So today, I will help you understand what are the most important signs that tell you that it's time to replace your pair of running shoes. There are a few things that affect the life of your running shoes. First of all, the weather condition. Is it sunny? Is it rainy? Is it very warm or very cold? What type of runner you are? Do you overpronate? Do you underpronate? Do you land on your heel or on your midfoot maybe? But also, and the most important actually, is the surface. Are you running on the road constantly or are you going off-road? Are you in the trails or on the tracks? Making sure you have the right shoes for the right surface will help you get the most out of your shoes. This all depends on what type of running shoes you're wearing and what type of runner you are. In general, we recommend replacing your Essex running shoes after 600 to 800 kilometers. A lightweight trainer probably closer to 600 and a maximum cushioning shoe closer to 800. We have seen instances where people have been happily running in their Nimbus for over 1,000 kilometers. If you want to start tracking your mileage on your shoes, we recommend to download the Runkeeper app. This will not only help you track your run, but also allows you to track the mileage per shoe. There are a few signs that it's time to move on to the next pair of running shoes. First of all, the outsole. When the outsole shows severe abrasion marks and it looks more like a slick tire than an outsole, then it's probably best to replace them. Secondly is the midsole foam area. If you see creases in the foam or the shoe looks deflated as a whole, it's probably best to move on to the next one. Actually, when you look at your shoe and you feel like I could only run this for two more months, it's probably already best to replace them. If you're unsure or want to get more advice, we recommend you to visit the ASICS store or go by your local run specialist to see if you need to replace them. The number one tip is making sure you're using the right shoes. Once you've found your perfect pair, we recommend you to clean it every now and then. On the website asics.com, you'll find an article exactly how to do that. And also very important, they'll tell you what not to do. When it comes to storing your shoes, we recommend to not keep them in too extreme conditions. Not too hot and not too cold. Also, don't keep them outside and store them in a dry place. And one final tip, after every run, undo your shoelaces before you take them off. And then keep the shoelaces undone before your next run. This way, the upper will remain more flexible and more comfortable for your next runs. All right, those were my tips for today. Now it's time to go grab your pair and see if they're up for replacement or if you can safely put some more miles into it. As always, go to the asics.com website to see how you can clean your shoes, but also to help you find your perfect pair. I hope you enjoyed this video and don't forget to vote on next week's topic. See you soon. Goodbye.